shelter is the body we put on over our bodies. This madness creep into the rooms and walls and corridors, the very boards? Don't we sometimes sense that madness reaching out to us? Isn't that a large part of what we mean when we say a place is unquiet, festered up with spirits? We say haunted, but we mean the house has gone insane.
Understand, my mother's here. Unless the house is imitating her, I suppose that could be. At first, I thought so, but the more I think about it, the more I think, and I got lost. I've seen things you wouldn't believe.
Not now, Emery.
We shouldn't be here, not any of us. There's a bubble forming, I think, a kind of psychic bubble.
What in the world would your mother be doing here?
She worries about me. I'm worried about me too, actually, about all of us. I saw Pam upstairs. I think she's dead.
Where's Annie?
I don't...
It's stuck again.
It's not just stuck.
Of course it isn't.
It's ridiculous!
Emery, come here. Is that your mother's car?
Yeah, I'm always a little scooted about.
What did you do?
Mommy's little scootabout, all right? Mommy's little scootabout. That's what she calls it, okay? Her scootabout. Sometimes we scootabout for ice cream, and sometimes we scootabout to the movies, and some... Stop looking at me.
I think Mama's little scootabout is blocking another car.
Is anyone in it?
I don't know. I can't tell.
I'm gonna check the kitchen door.
I'll go with you. Steve!
Not now, Dee.
Steve, come look at this. It's coming to life, isn't it?
I think he's somewhere right outside there. I didn't exactly see. In Ellen Rimbauer's room. She said things to me, bad things. I can't be sure, but when I see people like that, they're usually dead. This place is gonna kill all of us if we're not careful. We were wrong to come.
It is a cowardly and mistaken thing to say.
Vic's dead, Pam's probably dead, and we can't get out. You need a reality check, lady. Leave me alone.
Big deal.
Mom, where are you?
Is she all right?
I don't know. Go down to the kitchen, get a lemon. If there's no lemon, bring the vinegar. Go, hurry!
What about the windows in the billiard room? You were pounding on them with your fist. You don't think that the glass was stuck, too?
Careful now.
Mom? Mama? Who's there? Oh, I should be doing that. I should be doing that. Oh, I shouldn't be doing this. I shouldn't be doing this. Oh, screw it, I'm not doing this. If there's someone there, stop fooling around! Who's there? If you need help, I'll help you.
If you only want to play games...
Stay away from me! You stay away from me!
Sir!
Wait! Professor, wait!
Stay away!
No, but her breathing's strong and regular. Get Joyce.
Well, can I stay with her?
Get Joyce. She's a hell of a lot closer to a doctor than either of us. Go!
I saw Vic.
Yeah, you can't have Vic as...
Oh, I know. Vic was just another little Rose Red mind movie like Pam and Deanna Petrie. But I also saw Miller, and he was real.
Miller? Are you talking about Professor Miller?
None other, although I'm not sure the Dean of Arts and Sciences would recognize him. He's out there in the high grass, running around like a madman.
You're lying.
No, he's not.
No, I'm not. My mother's somewhere behind the house. I'm sure she is, but I can't get to the backyard. Not now.
All right, look, calm down, Emery.
Don't tell me that! You don't know what I've seen, so don't tell me to calm down.
I'll call 911.
I rather doubt it.
I think we all need to take a step back, take a deep breath, and...
Annie's had an accident. She's unconscious. Would you come?
Where is she?
This phone is working. Who shall I call?
The cops!
An ambulance!
No one! Not yet.
To hell with you, Joyce. I'm getting out of here.
Are you okay? Can you hear me? Emery.
You're not there. You're dead. Both of you are dead.
No, we're not. We're not dead at all, Emery. That's the beauty of it.
Rose Red's too much like the Roach Motel. They check in, but they don't check out. Not there. I'm hard up, girls, but not quite that hard up.
Annie, what is it?
We seldom have company at Rose Red these days. I insist you stay a little longer. Here, Annie.
Annie, no. Annie, be still and let her help you. It's okay.
Okay. Sorry. There you go.
Okay.
You okay, honey? Think you can stand up? Let's try. Oh, there we go. Great. Yeah, it's okay. Okay. Hey, Annie. Look.
In the sweet secret of the summer place is that it's anywhere when two people share all their hopes, all their dreams, all their love.
I know the song, and I know the feeling to be safe, to be free to dream, and to have all the time in the world to enjoy it. Yeah. Later on, I'll let you play with it all you want. Annie, look at me. Look at me. Annie, whoever wants to play with that dollhouse, you look at me right now. Annie, are you holding the doors and the windows closed? Don't give me that blank stare. You understand me perfectly well. We understand each other. Are you? Wants you to do, then you just go right on doing it. And soon, I'll take that dollhouse down and you can play with it all you want. In fact, we'll play with it together. And we'll take all the time we want.
Do any good.
So what's next, Sherlock? You got any ideas?
No. You?
No, no. This place has always wanted me. I found that out when I was 8. I should have stayed away.
Why didn't you?
Because of Dee. She needs someone to look after her so she doesn't just go floating off into the big nowhere. I mean... Here they come again. Hey!
Hey!
Get off him! Move on!
Hey, get off of him!
I think the power went out 15 minutes ago.
I don't think it'll be on again tonight.
Don't you want to know about Bollinger and Mrs. Waterman or Professor Miller? Aren't you curious at all?
What about them? Any sign?
No, none.
I think I knew that, actually. So, what is there to be curious about?
We're all in the billiard room. We need to talk. Pam is also missing, and if Emery says she's dead, I think we have to believe him. About Vic, of course, there's no question. Joyce, Do you understand what I'm telling you?
Of course. But since there isn't anything I can do about any of these people, not now at any rate, I'll continue with my observations. I am a scientist, you know. Or did you forget that?
No, I didn't forget that.
Miller did. Running around like a madman. Might have liked to see that. Thank God for battery packs.
Annie.
Don't waste your breath. She can't understand you. Can't even hear you, not in the sense that we understand hearing.
Annie. Annie. There you are. Would you like to come with me into the other room for a while? We could visit with Rachel and the others. Do you hear me? You do, don't you? Annie, come, please. You sure you won't come with us?
It's the last one, and maybe a little old, but sorry.
Beggars can't be choosers. Thanks. I don't suppose you have any nail polish in there.
Nail polish? No, I don't use it. Why?
We could pour some into a handkerchief and make her breathe it. Or what about drain cleaner? Just a whiff of that stuff and bingo, out like a light.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about survival, darling. Did I stutter?
Well, I think you're insane. Those things could kill her.
Oh, yeah. Gee. Having a good time, Professor? Enjoying the idea of visiting your former department head in the local nut barn? It'll try and take us tonight, you know. One by one or all together.
No, every time you open your mouth, you say something unpleasant, so why don't you just be quiet?
And not just unpleasant, it's wicked. Now, I know that you have had an accident, Emery.
An accident? That's right. I had an accident. Old unpleasant Emery knows something about our reporter friend.
Bollinger what?
Oh, no. I don't think so. No, he wouldn't want to hear from me. Every time I open my mouth, something wickedy-wickedy-wicked comes out. Why don't you tell him, Nick? I'm tired of being wicked. You do some of the dirty work.
Do you know something, or is he just talking?
The Mirror Library, right?
Yeah.
What about the Mirror Library?
Kevin Bollinger is dead. He brought Emery's mother into the house and then hung himself in the Mirror Library. Not so much a suicide as being Rose Red's latest victim.
What about Mrs. Waterman?
I can't see her. Or Professor Miller. What about you?
I don't know. This means they're probably still somewhere around here. There's someone in this place.
Please, a summer place where I'm safe and hidden.
You said you wanted to talk. Right, let's talk now, because I gotta go check on the equipment.
Did you intentionally decide to sacrifice this choice? Or did you simply ignore the probability of our demise?
I don't know what you're talking
about. Yes, you do. Or part of you does. But supposing you never get your proof? Did you even think about that? Supposing the proof isn't here to get, what then? Supposing Rose Red is just the paranormal version of the Energizer Bunny, and it just keeps growing and growing and growing
growing? Stop it. You're crazy. Didn't you see that he's crazy?
I'm not crazy. I'm a mind reader. You know that, and that's why I'm here. Now sit down! Rose Red won't let you have what you want, Joyce. It won't let anyone have what they want. Ellen Rimbaud designed it to break hearts as hers was broken, to hurt as she was hurt.
Well, then we have to get out of here before it can...
What, kill us? A real death would be merciful, because I doubt if even poor old Vic is really dead. And that's the worst of it, the very worst.
All right, so how do we get out? There are no secret tunnels, at least not that I know of.
Oh, wake up. She's the one who's keeping us locked in. Yeah, her. Little Miss Mental Illness of 2001.
Stop it. Losing his fingers has affected his mind. You mustn't hold it against him.
Wake up, sweetheart. Wake up, all of you. It locked us in when she was awake, right? Then, after she knocked herself out, everything opened up again. It was like a cramp letting go. We could have gotten away then if we'd understood what was happening and acted fast enough on what we knew. And one of us did understand. Joyce understood, didn't you, Joyce? And when the little bitch woke up again, I can't. My hand hurts too much. You know as much as I do. You tell him the rest.
Tell us he's insane. Start with that.
But he's not. Why did you want psychics and telekinetics and automatic writers here in the first place, Joyce? It was to recharge a cell that was never dead, merely dormant. And we have all played our part, I think. But Annie has been key. But what Emery doesn't understand is that Steve has been key, too.
Steve? Steve's about as psychic as a ham sandwich.
Please be quiet, Joyce.
Don't you tell me to shut up. How dare you?
He asked you to be quiet.
And do it, please. I want to hear this.
Everyone has some psychic capacity, Joyce. I've read your books and articles. You used to know that before all this psychic superstar infatuation stuff. And I know that Miller isn't the only imagination-challenged idiot that you've had to deal with, that you've become blinded and misguided.
I have not become blinded.
Whatever Steve's psychic ability in the outside world, here in Rose Red, it's amplified to the power of 10. Because he's blood. Ellen's blood. You said it yourself, Steve. You're the last of the Rimbaugh's.
Tell it any way you want. I'm not the one holding the doors shut and turning the window glass into whatever it is now.
No, of course you're not. Ellen's doing it through Annie, but also through you. And don't sit there and say that you don't know it, or at least sense
it. She's not doing anything through me. I don't sense that.
Stevie, look, please.
Would you like to help me build, Stevie? I'll show you how.
Steve? Stevie? Where are you?
Go to her, but come back.
We have to go.
Come
right
back
now.
And help me build. Help me build, Stevie.
Steve, what's wrong?
That was a false memory. The house planted it.
Are you sure?
No, I'm not.
For the time being, let's stick to the kid. If we take her out of the equation, the doors still don't open, we can worry about Rimbauer then.
No one is going to hurt this child.
Of course they're not.
And there's the rub.
We're in trouble, ladies and gentlemen.
Big trouble.
Play a game, Annie? You take 10 or 12 real deep breaths and squat down and blow on your thumbs. You'll get all floaty, and then you'll go to the North Pole with Santa Claus and his 8 tiny reindeer. The rest of us, meanwhile...
Stop it!
We'll scurry on out of here like the good little mice we are.
It's not funny!
Neither is this! Tell you what, sissy, let's find some dry cleaning bags. We can wrap her up just until she passes out. Or pinch your nose shut. Just...
Don't!
How about you, handsome? You're the utility infielder on this team. Can you knock her out with your mind? 5 minutes would be enough for us to make like bees and buzz. Hell, 3.
I can see her thoughts, but it's the most peculiar thing. They're
high.
Yes. High above me, as if she were a princess in a tower. And she's waving, but there's no way to reach her, at least not for me.
Annie, look at Ned.
What are we going to do with you, little sister?
How about this? Back of the head's the best place, just above the nape of the neck. Hit her hard, the lights go out. Hit her harder.
Oh, you ugly man. You ugly little troll.
Don't tell me you've never thought of it. Come on, do us all a favor. Do yourself a favor. Back of the head. Or do you want to spend the rest of your life wiping your kid sister's ass?
Stop it! Stop it!
Where are you going, Kathy?
I'm going to get a glass of iced tea. I saw a nice big pitcher of it in the fridge. Oh.
You shouldn't go alone.
I'm not. God goes with me. Everywhere.
Would you mind awfully letting her go? I guess not. Kathy, are you all right?
I think so. What about her?
My goodness, you really are a good Christian lady, aren't you?
Well, is she all right? Is she even alive?
Her pulse is strong and steady. You know who she is, of course.
Emery's mother. We'll have to tell him. You don't want to tell him?
Emma's, your mother just popped out of the wine cellar like Jack out of his box, and forget round the bend, she's off the planet. I mean, how does it sound to you, and given the condition he's in already?
Oh, sounds very bad. What should we do with her?
Annie, can you open the doors? Can you open the doors and let us out? Annie, look at me.
Ah! Ah! Don't touch her! Don't touch her!
It wasn't her. I thought it was April Rimbauer. I'm sorry. Damn this house. If only there were a way to get through to her, to reach the Annie inside.
You talk to her with your mind. I've seen you do it.
But it's not high. It's not where Annie lives. If only there were a way to...
What are you thinking about?
I'm not sure.
Where are Nick and Kathy? They should have been back by now. Why'd she have to go off on her own anyway? That was extremely stupid.
This is wrong to me. The woman is ill.
She's also dangerous to herself as well as to others.
Will those hold her?
I'd have preferred clothesline, but I think so. Besides, Emery gave me the impression that her interests run more to the home shopping network than amazing escapes. Drink up, it'll do you good. Here's to damsels in distress.
And the knights who rescue them. Coming in here alone was very stupid, but Emery so upset me.
Emery upsets everyone. Look at her. Well, I'm sorry, Kathy, but it's true.
Oh.
I think she's coming around. Now we only have to worry about Professor Miller.
Mrs. Waterman? Have you seen Professor Miller? Joyce's department head?
You killed my boy!
Now, Mrs. Waterman, you got it wrong. Emery's fine. That's it.
Liar! Limey Jack Tar!
Limey Jack Tar. I've been called many things, but never that.
I'm afraid we are going to have to leave you alone for a little while, Mrs. Waterman, only till you feel yourself again.
Kathy, come here. We're doing that. It's feeding off us. I mean, you must feel it, too.
Of course I do. Oh, dear Jesus, please get us out of here. We have to get out of here. Steve.
Steve couldn't hold us by himself. Not with me, you, and Emery working against her. No, the problem is Annie. Emery was right about that.
Could you...
Could I hurt her? I have the power. But no, of course I couldn't hurt her.
Spin again.
That's not funny.
Sorry.
What are you trying to say? Anything?
No. Oh, but it's so cold. It's coming from in there.
Close the door, then. Now, we're going to leave you, Mrs. Waterman, but not for long, and you'll be perfectly safe.
Something's happened to her.
Rose Red has happened to her. Come on, let's join the others.
Wait, I'm sorry we can't make you more comfortable, Mrs. Waterman, but we'll be back to get you soon. No, I promise.
And she's fried.
Oh, that's also unkind.
It's also true.
This is not the way we came.
You're telling me.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Seattle livery, 1924. But it's brand new. You'd have thought after all these years that she would have had Rose Red eat at least one halfway decent carpenter. Of course, the real question is, how does a ghost...
What is it?
The reincarnation of Emery's mother.
Nick.
Sorry, Kathy. The truth is, just now, I'm rather scared. Let's find the others.
We won't. We're never gonna see them again.
Of course we are. I promise. And I never break a promise. Come on, Kathy. Old friends is true friends. They're the friends you love the best. You never know with new friends. Old friends is best.
Hey, where's Rimbauer? I'm Frank and Babe's big sister.
To look for Nick and Kathy, I imagine.
And then there were three little Indians sitting on a shelf.
Gotta check the equipment. It's quite delicate, you know. Equipment which interfaces with the invisible world must, by its very nature, be quite delicate. Come with me, Annie?
Oh, leave her with me, why don't you? I'll take care of her.
Come on, Annie. Want to play with your dominoes?
One little Indian, down to one little Indian all by himself. Hey, Joyce, wait for me!
What are you doing here, Kathy?
Getting the scared out of me. What else?
Well, for the rest of us, yes, but not for you.
My therapist said I was a compulsive quitter. He said I keep starting things so I could stop them.
What did you say?
I stopped seeing him. So here I am.
Thank you. Listen.
Nick?
Run, Kathy, run!
Thank you. I can explain this, Ellen. She enticed me. She
enticed you. You can explain it. Can you explain it to your whores? Explain it to them down in hell.
What do you see?
I could hear her breathing. And I could smell her. Sometimes I see her with a doll and sometimes with a hammer. Maybe she's really the same.
Who are you talking about?
It's no one. Never mind. Come on. Years ago, and for trying to make me take the hammer.
How could Ellen still be alive?
Where has she been?
In the part of the house ordinary people can't see.
Her husband was no suicide. She killed him.
Wasn't Ellen.
Then who?
April.
But that means
that Ellen's somewhere still around here. Yeah.
Just hush now, Mama.
Help! Help me! Ah! Ah! Ah!
telling you, it was April Rimbauer.
Where's your proof?
We all saw it.
How many Indians left by midnight, do you think?
Please don't expect me to believe that your 90-year-old great-aunt is a vampire living in the tower. As a scientist, I just can't...
Don't be deliberately obtuse. It's the house that's the vampire, and I think you know that.
Obtuse? Oh, what a dreadfully big word for a college dropout. Wouldn't you say?
Why, what a sharp tongue you have, Grandma.
Another country heard from? Tell me, big sis.
Be quiet. I don't want to talk to you.
Oh, but I want to talk to you. I'm curious. How often do you dream of her dying? Tell the truth and shame the devil.
Stop talking like that! Why do you have to be so miserable?
Because I am miserable, you over-Christianized idiot.
Don't you touch her.
If he does, he'll regret it.
Oh, so strong and brave, threatening the man with four missing fingers. What good is she anyway? Just tell me that. She even knows she's alive. I doubt it.
Cut it out, Em.
Please, what can you do to me that's any worse than what this house is gonna do to me before the night is over?
I don't know. Send you out of the room, maybe? How would that be?
Alone.
Hey.
It's true enough. You're no good to herself, or to me, or to anyone. All she can do is help the house kill us, and it wants to. I'm not psychic, but I can feel that it wants to.
Yeah.
We're running out of time, aren't we?
Yes, and that's why we have to stay together. Come on.
Steve, you have to get through to Annie. You're the only one who can do it.
I've tried. Maybe I could on the outside, but whatever's in here has closed her off. Maybe you can...
Steve!
You have no idea how dangerous. You dare interfere with my...
Leave it alone, me.
They can't open themselves up to the forces in this house. It'll kill them both. It'll swat them like flies.
We don't have any other options.
No.
Here. Do you want to try, Annie?
Yes, Annie. Go ahead and try.
Let's do it together, shall we?
good.
You better stop. I'm warning you.
Go on. Go on, Annie.
Yes, go on.
Thank you. You wanted it then, and you want it now. If you don't take it, you'll want it forever. You'll never sleep without dreaming of it. Take it. Help me. Help us. Help Rose Red. Help us build.
Steve, no! Please don't take it!
He has no choice. He's one of us. Stevie.
But I do have a choice. I don't want this. Here, you take it. Let's get out of here.
think it's over.
It'll never be over as long as the house stands.
Roses mean remember.
That's right. Roses mean remember.
Monday
it is. The wrecking ball arrives promptly at 7.
That one for? I like your dress. Very pretty.
Can you still reach her with your mind?
No, but I don't have to. We communicate pretty well, don't we, Annie?